This is May. May's 12 years old and she's Japanese. She just moved here from Japan with her parents a few weeks ago when her mother accepted a position as a professor at a prestigious local university. As you can see, May needs orthodontic work. Knowing this, her parents decided to wait until after they arrived in the U.S. to have her orthodontic work done so she could finish it during her mother's professorial stint. While May is picking up English quickly, she still does not yet speak or understand it very well. As we'll see, that won't be a problem. The process starts when May and her father go to the closest local walk-in healthcare clinic. There, May is seen by a physician assistant who, among other skills, has had several months of training as an orthodontic assistant. The PA first takes a photo of May and then uses a scanner about the size of a large electric toothbrush to thoroughly scan May's oral cavity in about 1 minute. The PA then shows May and her father a selection of augmented reality images of May's own face with a range of different smiles based on those typical for Asian women of Japanese and other cultures. With her father's help, May selects the look that she likes best. May's photo, her intraoral scan, and her desired appearance are then uploaded to her blockchain-based electronic health records. Through an app on May's flexible smartphone, she and her father authorize the sharing of this information along with her insurance and contact information to certified orthodontists who have offices within a 15-minute drive of their home. This is Dr. Barbara Gutierrez, an orthodontist whose practice is based in an office about 8 minutes from May's home. She has an app running on her practice management system, which, among other things, continually scans for prospective new patients. The app notifies her that a 12-year-old named May, who lives nearby, is looking for orthodontic services. Dr. Gutierrez's practice management app analyzes the information from May's health record for her case, her intraoral scan, her desired outcome, and her insurance coverage. It then develops three preliminary treatment plans, each based on producing the desired outcome quickly and cost-effectively for the patient and profitably for the orthodontist. Dr. Gutierrez reviews the three plans. She eliminates one which she feels is unlikely to produce the desired result as reliably as the other two. She then asks her practice management system's intelligent assistant to schedule a conference call with May and her father for 10 minutes at a time that is available on all three of their calendars. It turns out there's a time slot open early that afternoon. On receipt of the call from Dr. Gutierrez, May and her father's smartphones instantly detect that Dr. Gutierrez is speaking English and translate her speech fluently into Japanese. Dr. Gutierrez's phone does the same thing so that each participant can both speak and clearly hear in the language of their choice. Later in the office, the same will be accomplished via nearly invisible earbuds which each person will be wearing and which are wirelessly connected to their smartphone's translation apps. After introducing herself, Dr. Gutierrez explains the two options she recommends and the advantages, timing, and costs associated with each. After some discussion, May and her father decide that they like Dr. Gutierrez and agree to schedule an appointment. Their intelligent assistants consult their respective calendars and identify a mutually convenient appointment time for early morning the day after tomorrow. When May arrives at Dr. Gutierrez's office, she and her father check in with the robotic assistant, who, of course, speaks Japanese fluently, along with approximately 600 other languages. May's a bit taken aback when the receptionist tells her that her initial examination is going to be done by a human assistant. Her father explains to the receptionist that in Japan, virtually all medical, dental, and orthodontic assistants are robots. The receptionist reassures May that Mr. Williams, who will perform the initial examination, is both very experienced and very personable, and that in fact he has a granddaughter the same age as May. She also explains to May's father that Dr. Gutierrez has already selected an excellent robotic assistant, which she will be using once Mr. Williams retires next year after having completed training of his replacement, of course. After Mr. Williams has completed the preliminary exam, he reports to Dr. Gutierrez that the reports and analysis of the treatment planning system appear to be valid. Then Dr. Gutierrez conducts her own exam and comes to the same conclusion as Mr. Williams. She shows May on the image display screen and her father a few key points and explains how and why the two alternative treatment plans differ. She concludes by recommending treatment plan B. Now, treatment plan B will take a little longer than plan A, 4 months versus 3 months, but the out-of-pocket costs will be considerably less for May's family, and the long-term results should be superior. For her own part, Dr. Gutierrez's margin will be slightly less, but still well within her practice guidelines. May and her father agree that plan B is the way to go. So the three of them authorize the treatment plan and the related payment schedule through their smartphones. This information is all recorded on a blockchain-based smart contract linked to her electronic health record. Once the smart contract has been executed, Dr. Gutierrez is authorized to download the design for a customized set of dynamic smart braces to the 3D printers in her office. These braces are descendants of smart brackets originally developed at the University of Freiburg in Germany back in the early 2010s. May's appliance will include brackets which continually monitor 6 vectors of force and movement for each tooth, adjust those vectors dynamically in accordance with the treatment plan, and upload the data continuously to her electronic health record via their built-in Internet of Things circuitry. Once the appliance designs have been downloaded, they are printed out in 4 parts on 2 of Dr. Gutierrez's 3D printers, one printer for the ceramic parts and one for the metallic. Dr. Gutierrez then assembles each set of braces and places them on May's teeth. The entire process of downloading the designs and printing, assembly, and placement is completed in just under 1 hour. May and her father approve the appliance through their smartphones and leave the office excited about May's new braces. On receipt of approval of the placement of the braces, the smart contract automatically transfers funds for the agreed initial payment into Dr. Gutierrez's bank account from both May's family's insurance company and from their designated account for their co-payment, which in this case is via using airline frequent flyer miles. Her account, Dr. Gutierrez's account, is credited for the payment by the time May and her dad reach the sidewalk. Over the next 30 days, Dr. Gutierrez's intelligent assistant monitors May's treatment daily. On 2 occasions when it seems warranted, it notifies Dr. Gutierrez to take a look at the results herself. In each case, after a couple of minutes review, Dr. Gutierrez concludes that May's treatment is progressing within appropriate parameters. Every 30 days, May consults with Dr. Gutierrez remotely to review her progress and provide personal feedback to the doctor. On the second such occasion, Dr. Gutierrez tells May that she recommends adjusting the treatment plan slightly to produce better long-term results. She explains that as a result, May will feel a little additional pressure on her upper right molars for the next few days. May agrees, and the doctor transmits the appropriate adjustments to May's braces, which begin applying the changes that night while May is sleeping. At the completion of each remote consultation, any changes to the treatment plan are recorded in May's electronic health record, and progress payments are automatically transferred to Dr. Gutierrez via the smart contract. After 4 months, May returns to Dr. Gutierrez's office for the final examination. They both agree that the treatment has produced the desired outcome. Dr. G removes the braces for the materials to be recycled. The smart contract automatically transfers funds for the final payment to her account, and May walks out of her office with a smile a mile wide.